I'm Jet Dunlap, and we're here with Dan, president of Black Magic Design. Now, Dan, you are holding in your hand something that kind of blows my mind because it's almost the size of an iPhone. Go ahead and tell me what this is.
So this is our new Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera. Wow. You know, we launched our Blackmagic Cinema Camera last year. Really impressive 2.5K resolution, high dynamic range, great for post-production. What we were finding was we wanted to have something that also had this amazing form factor so we can go out and get these quick, amazing shots that we'd sometimes miss by having a larger rig. So we had to make a couple compromises here. This is a 1080p camera. So we were working with a 1920 by 1080p. Still fantastic HD resolution. It still has the 13 stops of dynamic range. Totally amazing. It's a super 16 millimeter size sensor with an active micro four thirds lens. So so if you have the actual active lenses on there, you can control the iris, f-stops. But it has all that same quality that we see before on our cinema camera. The big differences here are we have a removable Nikon battery and it's recording ProRes and Cinema DNG to a standard SD card. So really flexible, open formats, off the shelf parts. The best part about this camera will be retailing for $995, wow, shipping in July.
Now, what I think is really, really cool about Blackmagic in specific is that you are a post-production company that went into the camera business. So when you go into cameras, you're thinking post-production. For a person like ourselves to go out and do interviews or go out and do, you know, something for a client, how valuable is that as far as like putting metadata on the spot? Go ahead and speak to that directly.
Yeah, you know, the big thing that we like about a lot of these cameras, of course, back to that form factor, being able to go out and get that great cinema quality, but everything that we think about when we build these cameras is, I mean, for years and years, we've been solving people's post-production problems. You know, how do I go, people go out and they make this great camera and it takes this great image and then everyone says, that's amazing, what do you do with it in post? And it takes years and years for this to all get kind of flushed out, and we make all this great. We've been spending years doing R&D for production. So suddenly when it came down to making a camera, it was like, well, geez, we have 80% of the R&D done because we've done all this production capability. So being able to tie things like our Resolve software, being able to take our current I/O technology and be able to use all of that, so we have this really seamless workflow with our own products, but also using formats like ProRes or the DNX HD on our larger cameras or the Cinema DNG RAW means that we're not completely married to Blackmagic as well. We can work with kind of anything. So we like that openness about our company that you can use some of our products, you can use all of our products, hopefully you use at least one of our products.
But one of the things I kind of want to close out with is your bad boy behind us here,
yep,
the Cinema Series. When I was looking at cameras to get into the next, we have a 7D, for instance. I'm like a lot of people. I have,
yep,
a 7D or a 5D Mark II.
Yep.
And I'm looking at the Blackmagic, and I'm looking at the 5D Mark III, and you know, there's more and more options every day,
yep,
right? And I see your eyes already.
Yep.
But where if you were speaking directly to us as an audience, young filmmakers or,
yep,
you know, new filmmakers, what would you say as far as what you offer over what else we have out there?
I mean, I think the big thing is going to be what can you get out there that's going to give you quite that beautiful cinema look,
right,
that in the back end of things is going to give you that post-production workflow that's going to A, speed things up, but give you that greatest flexibility. Because I think a lot of people go out there and they say, look at that image, it's beautiful, and they are beautiful,
yeah,
but beyond, you know, having that great cinema style image, you know, what are you doing with it in post? And being able to have that RAW or being able to work in Resolve, being able to have that high dynamic range, these are all things that are going to pay out big time when you're back in the, yeah, post-production room.
You know, Dan, I can already hear the post-production houses clapping for you. They're like, oh, thank God, someone's finally on our side. Dan, we really appreciate you taking the time to talk to us. It's been a pleasure, and we look forward to seeing what you guys have. When is the launch date on this?
So we're looking at shipping these guys in July, and again, retailing for $995.
Very exciting stuff. Thank you so much, Dan.
Welcome.